Welcome, everyone. This webinar is basically the extent of the support, aside from the software integration itself in the platform, in terms of getting people started, and then really it's up to them to follow their own intuitions and research and experimentations to find the result, and to support each other too via the modifications based on the community. The point of Node-RED is that the potential is infinite, basically, in the hands of the right developer and the right application. So we just give you the tools, and then it's on to all the people in the world out there to figure out how to implement it and integrate it in their own systems. But Dirk, who's from Victron R&D internal.
And then on the second part, my colleague Dirk, that is responsible for creating the nodes for almost all the Victron products, will show you some basic building blocks, some details regarding dashboard, automation, and also troubleshooting flow.
Yeah. Hello. Once you get Node-RED running, you first get your introduction here. As Hushem mentioned, you can click through it, which makes gives you some handy tips. It's also a way, once you click it away, you won't be able to see it again. But there's a trick for that as well. You can go to the help page, Node-RED, and start the welcome tour again, which is might be handy if you want to check that information. This is basically your screen where you start with. Yes, nodes on the left side with Victron nodes, a lot of Victron nodes as well. But first, let's start with a simple flow, which is injecting a timestamp into a debug node. You can just click and put them on the canvas. Once you have this, press deploy. This is your first flow deployed. It doesn't look, when you click on it, it only mentions it successfully injected the timestamp, but you don't see anything, not until you go to your debug messages. And then you see that a timestamp got inserted. And if you hover above the message, that it's coming from this debug node. Instead of injecting a timestamp, you can inject strings, numbers, booleans, and a lot of different things. Just say I want to enter the number, press deploy again, press, and then you get a number. The timestamp is the Unix timestamp, which means the seconds that have passed since the 1st of January 1970. This is simple. Just let's add a first Victron node. You can use the search bar for searching for, say, the system node, and you get all the system nodes. Let's pull this one. Say, I want to see the serial of the system, for instance. You can give the node a label. Say, I want to say this serial of my system. I pull that to the same debug node. You can also give this debug node a name, because by default it just keeps on numbering and it might be confusing which debug node you are watching. Say debug deploy this. Now it says it's connected, and there you see the serial coming in. It comes in every 5 seconds by default, which in case of a serial is not that interesting because it won't change. So that's why you can, for instance, put in a filter node. You can also grab these and then hover in between on the line, and then it's connected in between. What this filter node does is it filters messages that don't change. So if I press deploy, you don't see that. So you see a lot of messages still here. You can just clear them. First one was already in, so it does not show this the serial now again, but also it does not show it every 5 seconds. Also, if you would like to know a bit more about the nodes themselves, you can also click on the help button, which gives a lot of information on what a node can do, what the dbus, underlying dbus path of Victron nodes is, what enumerated values means. So if you get a DBA state, battery state, DC battery state, if you get code 0 out, that means it's idle. 1, it's charging. 2, it's discharging. So this help is really useful. And there's also for other nodes, it's like the filter node. It gives a lot of explanation on how the node is to be configured. There's also another trick, this green button, you can press it and then it stops it from debugging. Or at least showing it in the side pane. We can now grab an output node. We can also go below and then say we want to have relay control. The Victron nodes by default only show, like in this, the relays which are actually available on the device. So if I were to pull an EV charger which is not connected to my servo, this dropdowns remain empty. Only once you connect a EV charger to your system, it will start to pop up. On my example servo, I don't have a lot of Victron equipment connected yet. I do have a Ruby temperature meter on it, which I can also get from here, temperature sensor. If you right click, you also can insert your node, then debug, then it's double click it. It immediately sees that I have Ruby tag connected to it and I can take the temperature, pull it, deploy, go to my debug node. And if correctly, let's deploy, the temperature should get in. Yeah, there it is. And this one should come in every 5 seconds. And then there's a relay control, which we were starting with. As described here, it says there's 2 values, an open or a closed. So if I pull in an input node, inject node number 0. Set again 0 or open. You can also copy paste. Then I just, this was on a relay. So if deploy now, then I can push 0 and 1 to switch my relay of my servo. Do note that this only works if your relay is set to manual, which is in settings. It is set here to, it's now on if I, and it's switched also on the. So you can see that it's working. Let's see what else we got. It gets complex quite quickly, as you see with all the nodes I already have here. There is a trick to pull over, and then you can group your selection, which makes it a bit easier to see. Also, if you don't like the grid, there's also in the settings, you can say, I don't want to see the grid. So then it's white canvas instead of a gridded one. What we did notice with the temperature, that the rounding is a bit strange. There is a trick to solve that. You can pull in a function node. There are several tricks. There's with Node-Red and just like a normal programming languages, there are a lot of different ways to accomplish exactly the same thing. But for instance, if I say it, say load is, which makes it 1 digit after the comma. And then you can say deploy correctly, then the new debug nodes with debug, the new temperatures only have 1 digit, as you can see. This is a function node. It's also really handy if you do a little bit more complex stuff. Let's see, I got that. One of the neat tricks you can do with Node-RED, because it's really nice and useful just to be able to press a button here and then see what happens, is to see it on a dashboard. A dashboard does not come defaultly installed, but you have to install it manually, which you can do it via this menu, manage palette, install. Search for dashboard install. It takes a little while. There's a lot of extra nodes which you can install. All not supported by us, but really handy ones. Mark will show some. This takes a while. You can just close it and then it goes, it continues in the background. And then it says it installed extra nodes. And if left, look at it. There's a whole dashboard section now. So if I say I pull in Gorge with my temperature, I'll pull it from there. So you can. And then first times you have to click on this. You can give it all nice names, which Mark will probably tell you it is useful. Temperature label. Say it's somewhere between 0 and 30 degrees. You can say if it's between 20 and 30, then it's between 20 and 25. It's yellow. It's above 25. It's turning red. Done. Deploy. Then you can go to the same website with /UI appended. So needs to be HTTPS, not HTTP. And then you see my temperature again, which also is not rounded. And that's on purpose because I pulled it from here. I could alternatively pull it from here instead and go there. But also this temperature goes has some documentation, say message payload is searched for numeric value when it's formatted. If you use instead of value, deploy, go to the, then it's also rounded. So there's several ways to accomplish exactly the same thing, but this is all really neat. But if you get to more complex systems, you want to automate stuff. It's not just pressing buttons and just watching your temperature. So you can add an extra flow and pull in the temperature again. Say if you want to do something based on the temperature, not having to look at it, so you can say pull your switch node. Okay. There, if I say if its temperature is less or equal than say 15, and add another one. If it's larger than 20, just an example, then you can say I want to add. So as soon as the temperature is below 15 degrees, the output 1 will trigger. If it's above 20 degrees, output 2 will trigger. You can say my payload needs to be number 1. And then you can pull in the relay control. Yeah. You pull the same relay there. That one can also be copy pasted. And I say I want to make the payload 0. Here I switch something on, the relay on, here I switch it off, deploy. And now, depending on the temperature, it will either switch the relay on or off. And you can leave it unattended and the relay will switch based on your temperature. So you can switch a heater or a ergo or a whatever you want, or a pump based on temperature values, which is really the strong side of Node-RED. At least that's what I believe. You can also make it a bit simpler. Say if you have an inject node to trigger something. Say I want to set that. If you say you have a quattro or something like that to switch position on a certain time of day and of the day, you can just say at a specific time, say at 2:10 in the evening, I want to switch something on. You can say one, switch on, and then insert a, well, I don't have any actual devices attached, so it doesn't, I don't have the options to select some from a charge controller right now. But if so, you can just connect these again, and then it will switch on at 10 every day. They can do the same with the trigger off. There's also, there's a lot of examples on the web. This URL was not mentioned in Lucian's links, I noticed, but it will be added to it. This is the homepage of the Node-RED Contrib Victron nodes, and it also has a wiki link here, which gives some hints, just like the rounding, which I just used, but also some example flows, which is trigger-based scheduling, event-based scheduling. And a neat one, which I just added this morning, is solar forecasting. It uses the forecast solar and made this flow. Then copy it, show you how to import it. Yeah, via the menu, you can go to import, paste it, import. And this is adds a new subflow. A subflow is a combination of elements, just like a group, but then combined into a subflow. That's the way what Red calls it. This one allows me to set my longitude, latitude, the angle of my solar panels, the azimuth, the angle on which my solar panels are placed, how many kilowatt hour I have, an API key, which is not needed for a pub, for a normal account, how you want them added, how you want the result to be seen, deploy that. You can also use, I just only want to see things from the current flow. And this one is my, in my payload. It gives the result that this is my predicted yield. So this is the flow which is actually behind it. But this is getting quite technical now. So I think it's about time that I leave the presentation to Mark to continue. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you, Dirk. Very nice.